मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स कंटिन्यू एक्सरसाइज 6.1। क्वेश्चन नंबर 21। रवि ऑब्टेन 70 and 75 मार्क्स इन फर्स्ट टू यूनिट टेस्ट। फाइंड द मार्क्स ही शुड गेट इन द थर्ड टेस्ट टू हैव एन एवरेज ऑफ एट लीस्ट 60 मार्क्स। ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट x be the marks obtained by Ravi in the third test. Here it is given that average of these three tests. Okay, so average marks 70 plus 75 plus x divided by 3 greater than equal to 60. Okay, since here it is given at least. Okay, whenever it is at least in the question, then apply the greater than equal to sign. Okay, and now solve it. Inequalities, you will get it is 145 plus x greater than equal to 180. Okay, so x greater than equal to 180 minus 145 and x greater than equal to 35. So Ravi must obtain minimum 35 marks. Okay, at the last right, Ravi must obtain minimum 35 marks. Okay, to get an average. Of at least 60 marks. Okay. Let's start next question. Question number 22. To receive grade A in a course, one must obtain an average of 90 marks or more in 5 examinations. Okay. If Sunita's marks in first 4 examinations are 87, 92, 94 and 95. Find the minimum marks that Sunita must obtain in 5th examination to get grade A in the course. Okay, so first to solve this question, let x be the marks obtained by Sunita in the 5th examination. Now average marks +87 +92 +94 +95 plus x, okay, and divide by 5 is greater than equal to 90. Okay, so here it is 368 plus x greater than equal to 450. Okay students, so x greater than equal to 450 minus 368. So we will get x greater than equal to 82. Okay. So in the last step, you have to write that Sunita must obtain. Obtain minimum 82 marks. Okay. Question number 23. Find all pairs of consecutive or positive integers, both of which are smaller than 10, such that their sum is more than 11. Okay. So first of all, let x be the smaller of two consecutive odd positive integers. Then the other is x plus 2. Okay. First is x, then other is x plus 2. Okay. According to given condition, x is less than 10. Okay. And x plus 2 is also less than 10. It is given in the question, okay, that both of which are smaller than 10. And now second condition is given, x plus 2, sum of both is greater than 11. Now we solve this. Okay, from this it is 2x greater than 11 minus 2. Okay. Therefore, x is greater than 9 by 2. Okay. It means x is greater than 4.5. And from the first condition, it's clear that x is, you can write here, from first condition, x less than 10 and x less than 8. So combination of these two inequalities is x less than 8. Okay. And now x is greater than 4.5 and less than 8. And x is a odd number. Okay. So x can be take values 5 and 7. Okay, x can take values 5 and 7 only. Okay, so required pairs will be 5, 7 and 7, 9. 5 is x and it is x plus 2. Okay, same as here, in place of x 7 and x plus 2 is 9. Question number 25. The longest side of a triangle is 3 times the shortest side and the third side is 2 cm shorter than the longest side. If the perimeter of the triangle is at least 61 cm, find the minimum length of the shortest side. Okay. So first of all, let length of shortest side x centimeter. Okay. Then length of longest side will be students, it is a 3x centimeter. Okay, it is given in the question that longest side of a triangle is 3 times the shortest side. Okay, and length of the third side, it is 3x minus 2 centimeter. Okay, it is also given that third side is 2 centimeter shorter than the longest side. Here longest side is 3x, so third side is 3x minus 2. Okay, and next it is given that perimeter is at least 61 centimeter. It is at least, that's why apply the sign greater than equal to 61 centimeter. Okay, and now substitute the value of perimeter. Perimeter means sum of the side of a triangle. X plus 3x plus 3x minus 2. Okay, greater than equal to 61. And now solve it. We will get 7x is greater than equal to 63. Okay, therefore x is greater than equal to 9. X is the shortest side. Okay, therefore the minimum length of shortest side is equal to 9 centimeter. Okay, this is the answer.